You're watching NBC6 News Today.
NBC6, we've got your back. We're joined by Tracy Maxfield, the author of the book Escaping the Rabbit Hole, and she is here with us to tell us all about it. First of all, thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
Now, tell me a little bit about your book. It's your story, essentially, and yes. Tell us a little bit about it and why you felt the need to write it.
So in 2015, after experiencing some workplace bullying, I ended up having an acute depressive episode. Mm-hmm. And so I actually wrote the book because I wanted people living with depression to know that they're not alone. Mm-hmm. And what they're going through is actually horrible, but normal.
What are some of the signs, or maybe some of the things that, because some people might think, oh, I just have a bad day at work, but there's really a difference between that and then actually going into like a depressive situation.
Yes, it was the intense feeling of hopelessness, mm-hmm. and sadness, and feeling that I was encased in cement. I'd not experienced physical side effects, mm-hmm. before, and it was the suicidal thoughts, something that I had also never had in previous episodes. Mm-hmm. And it was just the feeling that life wasn't worth living, that I couldn't possibly go on, there was no future.
And you wrote this in your book, Escaping the Rabbit Hole, and that's sort of probably how you describe your journey.
Yes. So I felt like I'd fallen down, mm-hmm. or pushed, more like, down a rabbit hole. It was very dark, mm-hmm. it was very cold, it was damp, and there was only a little chink of light, mm-hmm. which was really, really the sky, very far away, and I likened myself in a rabbit hole. It felt very earthy. I could imagine, mm-hmm. there were roots around me, and so from the moment I fell down, I had to begin planning my escape, otherwise I knew I would surrender and die.
And so now you're taking this and sort of empowering yourself and others with your story. You're not just talking about mental health issues, but also bullying and specifically how it affects kids and teenagers today.
Yes. So I'd actually invited to a school, mm-hmm. and when I was talking to teenagers ages 11 to 15, so many of them came to me to share their stories of mental illness and bullying, mm-hmm. and I was heartbroken, mm-hmm. because when you're a kid, you're supposed to be a child and enjoy life. And when I did more research and I realized just how many of our kids are actually living with a mental, mm-hmm. illness, and those that are being bullied, 1 in 3 students, mm-hmm. in school are being bullied, I decided that that would become my mission.
And there is so many other resources that you've got, as well as the,
yes.
book on her website, and we've got that link for you up on your screen now, but we'll also have it for you, a directly link built into our website, arklatexhomepage.com, so you can get information as well, and to, if you know or you are dealing with something like this or you know someone, these are some great resources. Thank you so much for being with us
Thank
this morning.
Thank you. My pleasure.
All right, your time now is 6:53, and coming up, Josh is back with a final check of your forecast.